gorgeous. It is always great to see you. Thank you so much for coming back to the show.
Oh, I love being here.
Okay, good. Thank you. You were telling me backstage that you recently became an American citizen, by the way.
I did.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I'm so happy.
Yeah.
You'll be voting for the first time?
For the very first time.
Congratulations.
And I'm so excited about that. Thank you.
Are you excited to vote?
I'm very excited. You know, my father's a politician in Kenya, but I was never there for the election, so I was never able to vote for him. Oh. So it means a lot to me to finally be able to exercise my democratic right.
Yes, exactly right. If you're eligible to vote, make sure you're registered. I also wanted to talk to you about this because I read somewhere that you are getting into cold plunges, and I don't know, is it true?
Yes, it is.
No, I've never actually. I did one on the show with Mark Wahlberg, where we sat in the bathtub together. But and I've been doing it for the past year and a half, and it's great. Mark and I, yes. But what got you into this, and how long do you go in? And I'm afraid of it.
Well, it was part of my training for Wakanda Forever. Oh, yeah. My trainer got me into it. Shout out, Lacey.
Yeah, come on.
And so I tried it then, and I hate the cold.
Yeah.
I hate it.
Yeah, me too.
And so it was very hard for me to start. But then the feeling after you get out, you feel like a superhero. I mean, you can do anything.
Really?
In the minutes after that. Didn't you feel that?
Kind of. Like, close to that emotion.
I feel
wet. And, yeah, and I go, why? I kind of said, why?
Wow.
No, but I did feel a little invigorated.
Yeah.
But I mean, how long do you get in there? Because Mark and I were only in for a little bit.
I get in there for about 3 to 6 minutes.
No.
I listen to a good song, and whatever length the song is as long as I stay in there.
That would really affect that song for me. I would never think of that song the same way. Like, no. Oh, my gosh. You brought us a video of you finishing a cold plunge.
Yeah. This is what this is, I...
Look at this.
Wait, well,
no. That doesn't look... You think that looks fun? That looks like... That does not look like you're having a good time at all. I want to talk about your podcast, by the way.
Oh, yeah.
Congratulations on this.
Thank you.
Mind your own.
Thank you.
You created your own show.
I did.
Tell everyone why you wanted to do this.
Well, I love podcasts, especially the storytelling shows. Yeah. And when I first moved to this country, I was really homesick, and I started listening to This American Life, and I loved it. Because you're meeting one person in America, and it just made me feel more at home in this country. And so when I was thinking about what I wanted to do, I envisioned this podcast where we could hear stories from the African perspective, because I missed home and I wanted to feel home one story at a time and kind of expand what it means to be African in today. And yeah, so I wanted to...
Good for you. This is it's out September 19th and it's available everywhere you get your podcast.
Thank you.
Now, let's talk about your new movie, The Wild Robot. It is 100% fresh on Rotten Tomatoes. It is a beautiful animated movie. I want you to read some reviews here. The Wild Robot is a jaw-dropping, possibly one of the best films of the year. An animated triumph. Yes. An animated triumph destined to become a classic. Here's one here. If there was an Oscar category for voice performances, Nyong'o's The Wild Robot is probably the strongest argument you could make for it.
Oh,
congratulations.
Wow.
Peter, that's big. That's awesome.
It's big change, big change.
It's an animated film, and I heard that you lost your voice.
I did.
Halfway through this thing. What happened to you?
So the character I play, Roz, is a robot that starts off in her factory settings, and then as she adapts to this wild island that she finds herself on to, you know, complete her task, which is her mission in life, she becomes more human. And so in the process of doing that first voice, that sort of like Siri, Alexa, very, very, very optimistic voice, I hurt myself in the booth.
It is very optimistic, those Alexas, yeah.
Like, yeah.
Yeah.
And so I got a polyp, and so the surgeon said that I had a 30% chance of curing myself naturally, or else I would need surgery. And I spent 3 months on vocal rest.
3 months?
3 months.
No talking?
I was using a bedroom voice.
Ooh.
So I could only really talk like this.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Is that hard to do for 3 months?
It was a lot of work. I mean, I realized how much my personality relies on me speaking. So I just became a very different person.
I mean, just not only communicating, but what if you go to a concert or something?
I did. And I went to the Taylor Swift concert and I went to the Beyonce concert.
And you didn't do any, you didn't sing any songs?
I was like a Zen master. Because I couldn't even, like, I couldn't even mouth the words, you know? I couldn't even think of singing in my head. I couldn't. I was just like,
I'm just gonna shake, shake, shake.
Yeah, it was torture.
Oh my gosh. Is that before you did Quiet Place?
It was after, which wasn't helpful, was it?
That's a lot of quiet time, is what I'm saying. Oh my gosh.
I know.
Good on you. What did you think when you first got asked to do the voice of a robot?
I thought, whoa, okay. How do you play a robot that doesn't have feelings?
Yeah, because I would just be like, hello, how are you? That's why I don't get these roles. Exactly.
Well, I did experiment with some very robotic voices. The good thing about animation is it takes a long time, so you can try things out and throw them out if they don't work.
You're so good. The Wild Robot is based on a book. Can you tell everyone what it's about? It's so cute.
Yeah, it's about this robot called Rosm7134, and she gets stranded on this island. She doesn't know she's lost, and she's programmed to complete tasks. So she tries to find out who on this island would have bought her so that she can help them out. And all the wild animals are terribly afraid of her, but she lands on a task that changes the course of her existence and her programming.
Oh, that's perfect. Well done. That's the best anyone's ever set up. And it's a little cute. Oh my God, it's beautiful animation and great cast, by the way.
Yeah.
Pedro Pascal, Catherine O'Hara. I want to show everyone a clip. Here's Lupita Nyong'o in The Wild Robot. Take a look.
Oh, okay. Wow. Hello. This gosling is yours.
Negative. That gosling stalks me, emits noise, and makes simple tasks more complicated or impossible.
Yeah, they do that. Goslings imprint on the first thing they see. Which would be you?
Congratulations!
As far as he's concerned, you're his mother now.
I do not have the programming to be a mother.
No one does. We just make it up.
Without an assigned task, my next priority is to return to factory.
Taking care of him is your task now.
Task acquired. Return mode delayed. A Rosm always completes its task.
Oh my gosh, it's so... Lupita Nyong'o, everybody. The Wild Robot is in theaters and IMAX September 27th. More Tonight Show after the break. Stick around, everybody. Hey, hey.